Welcome to Sports Vision on WTMB. Joe Palo, Mike Cragen, Bear Cragen, take two, and the chocolate chicken as we celebrate, as we said, nice weather, beautiful days, beautiful nights.
Great weather.
The ball.
Weather.
And then we got a special thing.
Yes, we do. The whole community is aware of the fallen hero, Sergeant David Ware, and held a service for the whole community at the Bradley Stadium last night, Wednesday night, and it was a very, very touching thing. Taryn Bergeroff, his niece got up there, and it's just going to tug at your heartstrings. But, of course, the entire community showed their support and condolences for Sergeant Ware.
Celebration of his life.
Celebration of his life. Wanted to be a soldier his whole life, and it was something that was attended. It was a good thing. It made you feel good in some respects. Of course, you just hate to see someone that young pass on. But what a great, great community support. We're going to show some of that. Of course, we've got our normal stuff.
We do
high school football. Bradley and Soddy, Damon Floyd now two.
Big region game over Soddy last week.
Two wins. That's at Bradley Central High School. As you know, that's a pretty big event this early in the year. And some freshmen. There's some good-looking freshmen on both sides of the ball coming up. But one man totally dominated the freshman game. We're going to show you. His last name starts with a P, for those of you Cleveland fans out there.
And it's not Palo.
It's not Palo. Definitely not Palo. But we need to get after, because we're going to show you some great things. And stick around for a nice tribute to a local hero. And let's give kudos to everybody for the support they gave.
Yeah.
All right. Soddy Daisy. Bradley.
Here we go. The Bears and the Trojans from Soggy Daisy. Bears breaking through the banner. Here comes.
Say it again. Moultrie's all wet.
He is all wet. He usually says Soggy Daisy for some reason because it is soggy there. And let me tell you what. The Bears, folks, this is a new Bear team. Bears in white on D, the D side of the ball, and they swarm, taking down Soddy Trojan right there for right at the line of scrimmage. Joe Moody now back and bigger and better than ever as he gets a great run here on the first offensive play for Bradley. Good to see him back on the field again. More D now for Bradley. Nice hit by Casey Humphreys. Watch number 77 here. We'll take off the block and then bam!
Boom!
Right down he goes. Good job there. Back on O. Sweet, sweet pass play. Chris Rogers finds Mark Gibson off a fake double reverse and then a nice long pass. Gibson makes the catch. Right there. Good job. All right. Moody. More tough running for Bradley Central. And Moody just takes it around the right side there and breaks a tackle or two and gets some great yards. Moody again, and just dealing out the punishment. It's hard to stop this kid.
Right,
good
there.
Hard runner. Timmy Lynn now would hit Brandon Kofell. As the play goes deep inside Soddy territory. Good job here by the Bradley Bear offense. Soddy would hold, but watch the play as Gibson would strip the running back of the ball. And then he and Jesse Lascuto, watch this right here. Strips the running back. He and Lascuto kind of bobble it around, take it into the end zone, and then guess what? Casey Humphreys, a lineman's dream, falls on it for the touchdown. Bradley Central in a big way now. Bradley looking great. Humphreys, you'll see it again. Humphreys with a great recovery for Bradley Central, and this kid
nice
has worked
game. By Gibson and Moody there. Too.
Yeah. Two fumble recoveries
Gibson
for Casey.
Lascuto.
A couple of sacks and everything for Humphreys. So Bradley with the
and he's one of our biggest fans, so we like
yes,
him.
Yes, and I love that kid.
I do too.
You, great family, Teddy and Ann. PAT for Bradley Central would be good, as you'll see here. Freshman kicker remembering that. Through the uprights, good. 7-0 Bears in the lead over the Trojans. Oh my goodness, could it be? Bradley back on O later. Moody, another nice run. Just eating up yards. Eating
I think they
the
could
clock.
Beat Dalton this year.
They would beat Dalton this year. Dalton better be glad they're not playing.
Look at the punt.
Later, Bradley Central punting. And look at the hit by Kofell. Watch out, right. Take him down right there. Brandon Kofell. Great job. And then D again. Humphreys recovers his second fumble of the evening right there. Number 77. All right. So now watch this hit. Watch this hit by Matt Reisenhuber.
And we've seen one.
We've seen one. Tez Davis remembers that.
Tez Davis decleat.
But watch this. Watch this hit right here. As he got the leg, boom, and take him down.
Look at the coaching staff run over.
Let's see it again. Boom, 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 boom. Down he goes. Nice hit by Reisenhuber. And then, of course, next play, we've got an interception. Gibson would stop the Soddy Daisy drive right there, all together with a great interception. Mark Gibson playing some ball this year as well.
Isn't this blocker's good on the return, too? I like it.
He really did. And look how he takes the ball outside as he goes to the outside.
You taught him. Actually, I had him. You didn't have him.
That's right. That's right.
Had him.
He just knew that I was coaching it from the other side of the ball.
Yeah, right. Here we go.
Second and goal after another interception. Lynn would hit Logan Watson for the TD after the interception for the touchdown. PAT now on this would be blocked. But Bradley, fear not, Bradley still goes up 13.
There's the block.
Down to nothing. 13 tip. And this would be the score at halftime, as you'll see. Block kicking down. Now let's listen to the band.
Look at these guys.
The flies
shooing flies. The flies were heavy that night.
You know what I think is killer? I mean, Bradley Band playing a little Zep, Led Zeppelin. That sounds great.
One of the greatest bands in history. Top two, anyway.
Here we go. Third quarter action. Lynn
and Watson.
Pick up where they left off. Great reception right there. Kofeld now would get some yards outside. Brandon Kofeld turned out to be an excellent runner.
Pretty good back.
Yeah, he is. And then of course. There's the sign there, you know, Brad Beef again, Trojans, the whole thing. And then, watch this nice tackle right there, Moody. And then Josh Cunningham, he gets into the action. Knocked the pass down. Watch this. I think he's going to, no, you're not going to throw it. You're not throwing it. Bears make a mistake on offense, fumble deep in their own territory. Saadi recovers inside the five. However, fear not, Bears. Play great D and go on to win this ball game by a score of 13-6.
Hold on the
big
defense.
Region win.
Coach Floyd said he was a little bit disappointed maybe with their offensive output, even though we saw some of the highlights there. So there's still some good things going on. And you know,
but how many times in recent years has Bradley been able to beat Saadi Daisy?
Exactly. They beat Saadi Daisy. They're coming out with two wins. And Warren County's won a couple ball games. Yeah. So they are improving. They got a ways to go. Obviously, they're not going to win the region or anything like that, but they've improved under Coach Floyd. And things are starting to come up. Big game this weekend.
Bradley Walker.
Oh, and tell me we're not going to have some highlights next week.
Yeah.
Because we're going to be on the field.
Both bands?
You're going to be on the field with Football Friday cameramen. We're going to be on the field with the SportsVision camera. We're going to have all kinds of angles and dangles from that thing.
Yeah.
We'll be right back after this commercial break. We've got some more football for you, the freshmen this time.
My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours. It's better than yours. I could teach you, but I have to charge. My milkshake brings all the boys to the yard, and they're like, it's better than yours. My milkshake is better than yours. My milkshake is better than yours. My milkshake
milk
is better than yours.
Shakes. Hand-scooped shakes and malts with M&Ms. New at Hardee's.
Welcome back to Sports Vision. Joe Palo, Mike Cragen.
I say this every time, but I want one of those every time I see
them.
Well,
we have had them. They were delicious.
And you want to stick around if you're viewing out there, because we're going to show you some highlights of the ceremony for Sergeant David Ware in his passing, falling for his country here and our hometown. So we're going to show you some of that. But we got some football first. But hang around, because there's some special moments in this thing you're going to want to see, some touching moments. First of all, however, we are going to show the freshmen. And I'll tell you what, there's a kid in ninth grade, Terrell Parks. Write it down right now, because you're going to
know him since he was like this.
We've known him since he's this high. We are going to be talking about this kid constantly. And let me show you why. Let's look at the freshmen. This was Bradley in Cleveland at Bradley High School. Here we go. This is the opening kickoff. And guess what? This is Terrell Parks. Check this out. And we're going to start right from the top, and we're going to end up with him. Look at this. Moves extraordinaire everywhere. He's got him. He got in the open there in about 2 seconds. Here he is all the way for the touchdown. Terrell Parks. It's already 7-0, the Blue Raiders, after the PAT right here. And as you're going to see it, it's going to go through. Trust me, I've seen this before. 7-0. There it is.
You know, and every time you watch it, it'll go through.
Yeah, it just always does.
Never misses it.
All right, Cleveland D right here. This is Will Marland right here as with a hit in the backfield. Next play, BC tries to go deep, and it's an INT by Jameel King. This is a tall young man, tall receiver, and he also plays defensive back. Look at this, Jameel King with the INT for Cleveland. So right away, Cleveland back in control. Bradley D will stiffen a little bit though, right? Look, they're going to get the tackle on the quarterback right here as they all kind of crash in and get him. And Davis and Parks are trading out right here. That's Davis number one, Parks number three, and that combination is going to be good. I shouldn't leave Marcus Davis out of it because I'm telling you, he's also something in the long line of Davis's. Aguilar right here gets an 8-yard pass. Chris Aguilar from Jackaway. And now Cleveland with the ball. It's Marcus Davis with some power running right here.
Another Davis.
Another Davis. That's that Davis family just keeps right on coming. This is followed up with a nifty run right here to the 2-yard line by number three, Terrell Parks. I tell you, the kid was all over the field.
We may just change Terrell's name to Davis.
Yeah, Terrell Parks, right. Terrell Davis. Denver Bronco. Davis picks up the TD now in a 2-yard run. So Parks set it up. Davis takes it in, and that combo is going to be lethal. PAT good, 14-0 Raiders. Bears on offense, but look at Cleveland. This is Chris Robb. Look at him blow this play up right away. Mm. He's going to strip the ball, and he's going to come back and just about get the tackle and get in on it a little bit right there. But good defense by Chris Robb. After Bradley punt, it's Parks again. Look at this punt, and it's Parks again one more time after the punt. You're not going to see the punt. You're going to see Parks. And look at him go right back down to the two again. He likes the 2-yard line. Yeah. I'll follow and let my buddy take it in. And guess who his buddy is? They're going the other way this time because the quarter ended
it's
on that run.
One, so it's a Davis.
Yeah, it's Davis. It's Davis. All right, bright moment by BC as the PAT is blocked. It's 20-0 now. And later in the second, the Raiders, again, they'll regroup after the BC defense swarms right there. But Parks in the backfield right there. Will Hall's the one that got him. But Parks, right away, is going to make up for it. They had a big loss. He's going to get a great scramble. It's going to be 14 yards. You can see it's going to be pretty. He's going to break out of two or three tackles right there. Get the first, get close to the first down. On fourth down now, Parks is going to get it to Davis. And Davis is going to push it up right here as he's going to go all the way to the Bradley 8-yard line and a first and 10. And Jameel King will get the call. Nice run right here. An end around by King. And look at this. He's going to get through a few people. He's going to take it all the way down to the three. Yeah. Davis is going to
Where's the hash mark?
Davis is going to take it in from there. And Davis now, that's his third TD. So how about that? As he's going to take it in. PAT good. 27-0 Cleveland. Here comes your PAT. And it's good again.
Yeah.
All right, look at the hit right here.
I want kickoff.
Defenders is going to level him. Look at this. I think this is Quan Hooks. I could not get the number, but it was a great hit. He went through the blocker and got the hit. That was pretty awesome right there to take them both out at the same time. BC on O. Aguilar is going to pick up about 6 yards.
As in Louie?
He's a good wrestler. There's Aguilar twins. They're both good wrestlers. Aguilar again to midfield.
Louie.
It's Chris and Victor. And let me tell you, they can wrestle. You're going to hear about them. Pass completion here to Vince. I said Chris. It's Vince. Right there is Vince. With the pass, 27-0, Raiders at the half, big. Early third, Parks again, swarmed by BC, by Hall again. Look, so they all got him twice. So we need to show the Bradley side of the football on that, even though Parks pretty well dominated this game. But elusive Parks again, look at this, comes up with another great play. Check this out on the scramble, Joe. I mean, he's just tough to get down.
Reminds and me of looks, my buddy Juwan Smith.
Look at him, look at him, look at him, look at him. I mean, you thought he was down twice. And there he is. Finally, an offensive spark there for Bradley right here as this right here, Thaddeus Ramsey, takes it up the middle, as Joe says, and he
could
go all the way.
Wait, touchdown.
Bradley touchdown, 80 yards right there. So Bradley does have a nice highlight. They would miss the conversion, however, 27-6. Cleveland right back. It's Parks again with a good run. Parks going to tack on 12 more. Who's this Parks kid?
Terrell.
I mean, he just keeps on coming. Look at it, 12 more.
Who is Terrell Parks?
And he does
he
it.
He is.
And he does it on defense, too. Anyway, Parks going to zig and zag. Look at the TD. He's going to get a little zig, a little zag. Here comes the zig.
Look at that.
Here comes the zag.
You know Coach Wilson.
Look at this.
Chomping at the bit to get him up in the varsity.
Well, he plays some. I mean, he plays some right now.
Yeah, but I mean, really.
Yeah, when he's playing all the time. 33-6 after the extra point's good. And I'm telling you, a kid just, he took over the football game. Ramsey. Another nice run here for BC as we go to the other side of the football. BC on offense. And another bright spot after Ramsey's run right here. He's going to get pretty good yards, about 16 yards. Quarterback Danziel Jackaway is going to hit a TD pass right here, covering 60 yards. This is Aguilar, Chris Aguilar, on the reception. So Bradley gets on the board again. Nice, pretty pass. Good reception right there in traffic by Aguilar. The conversion's no good. 33-12 now. BC is going to try an onside kick. It's successful. So Bradley trying to mount a mini comeback right here. However, BC is going to be forced to punt. And we are now in the fourth. And it's Parks again. Look at this. Off the return. I mean, he's the quarterback. He's the return man. On the punts, on the kickoffs. He's a tailback when Davis plays quarterback. But look at this. He's swamped again. Look at this reversing the field. It reminds me of watching Levante almost in ninth grade, how he just come out there and dominate a football game. Davis picks up 12 more right here. So his buddy Marcus, now see how they switched? Marcus was a quarterback for a while. Now they're going to put Parks at quarterback. They go back and forth with those two, quarterback and running back. Parks makes even a bad snap look good. Look at this. He gets a bad snap, gets 20 yards back, and then he picks up the 20. Right back again. Instead of getting covered up right there.
I think that was a design play.
Yeah, it must have been. Marcus Davis finds Jameel King right here on a nice pass for a touchdown. Look at that.
Look at that beautiful pass.
King comes back for the ball, falls over. He's like 6'3", falls over the goal line right there. And the angular King falls over, PAT. No good this time. It's 40-12. Parks still in the game, 40-12. But look, he's still making good plays. Look at this. TD run. Check this out. Look at this. I'm telling you, just juking players. All right, but they take that one away on a penalty. So it comes back. Raiders are ahead now, trying a field goal. Now, I kind of wondered about this. You know, they try to field goal. It's blocked. Way ahead in the fourth quarter.
Field goal from 70 yards out.
Nice hit at the end of the game. Guess who hit? Look at this hit over here. Check this out as you see. Check the hit. Right there. Oh, guess who it is?
Terrell.
Still in the game. Terrell Parks playing defense, playing offense. And I'm telling you, look at the hit again. Oh, beautiful. That's right. And then at 40-12 is your final and the freshman Cleveland. And you know they've got a great sophomore class with Tipton.
Oh, yeah.
And with the whole crowd they've got right there in the sophomore class, Monty Scotton.
Monty.
A bunch of other. So they, Cleveland, I've seen a lot of talk, chatter on the internet and stuff. They're saying, hey, this sophomore class and this freshman group you saw right here, look out, everybody.
And when they're full-fledged every down with the varsity
and
team.
And they get sophomores and juniors. So we're
Cleveland. Get a little bit more experience.
Cleveland's future looks bright.
I'll tell you, we always talk about it. They don't ever, you know, rebuild, they
but
reload.
This may be the best back-to-back.
I believe it.
Coming up.
And we've seen these kids from, like I said, when they were like that.
Commercial and then a very touching ceremony. We'll be right back.
What do you do when your cash is low and you need groceries?
You got a cash emergency, you got a money mayday.
Chicken to cash.
What's Chicken to Cash?
It's a remarkable place to get instant emergency cash for a flat fee.
We cash your personal check and then we hold it till your payday.
Anytime you have an unexpected expense and need a payday advance, Chicken to Cash can make it happen.
Chicken to Cash.
The next time you need quick cash for whatever reason, go to Chicken to Cash.
You got a money mayday.
The Spot Restaurant in downtown Cleveland has served four generations with chili, hamburgers, and Frosties, and is a tradition in this community. Open Monday through Saturday, The Spot offers the best hamburgers, chili, and Frosties anywhere. Whatever you do, be sure to make The Spot a part of your dining experience this week. The Spot is located in the heart of downtown Cleveland. The Spot, bringing great food and fine folks together for good times.
Welcome back to Sports Vision, Joe, Mike, Bear, and Chicken.
And a very sobering piece right here and a tribute to one of Cleveland's own, a native, a young man that went to Bradley Central High School.
Played ball there.
See him being honored, his jersey being retired. They bought some lockers in his name. We got excerpts of the ceremony held last night in Jim Smitty, in the actual football arena. And a lot of people got up and spoke. But the thing the brother wanted to remind is that he went after his duty and took it on with a challenge and didn't
willingly.
Shirk it. Willingly. And also that he said, remember him with a smile, because there were some stories told, and evidently he was a fun young man to be around, and he will be missed by his family and the community. So let's honor Sergeant David Ware with a little bit of the ceremony, and we'll see you all next week.
Have a good week.
Well, we can't check out yet. Let's describe this to begin with. This is Damon Floyd and the football team coming in.
Stadium.
Yeah, and we'll be checking out here in a minute, but this is just preliminary. As you saw originally, also, they came in from the front entrance, the back entrance. The whole community was there, Joe, panning the crowd. And they are great support for this young man.
This young man is what heroes are all about.
That's right. A lot of us would like to think we are, and I don't think very many of us really are. There's the family coming in, and we're going to hear the next.
At a very young age. David, we salute you and we thank you for your duty, honor, and country. The Screaming Eagles, the 101st Airborne Division, what a legacy we have in this community from our own Command Sergeant Major Paul Huff to today, Sergeant David Ware. Gavin, from your dad, a hero in your sight for the rest of your life and in our sight forever as well. David played on this football field. He gave his life so that every Friday night when there's a home game, we can assemble on this field and watch the Bradley Central Bears play, as well as all of the other stadiums across our great nation. Thank you, Sergeant Ware, for continuing our freedoms as we know them today. Whereas Sergeant David Ware is a prime example to the young and old alike of Cleveland and Bradley County as to what kind of individual it takes to be called a true hero. Now therefore, we Tom Rowland, Mayor of the City of Cleveland, and D. Gary Davis, Mayor of the County of Bradley, do hereby proclaim Wednesday, September the 20th, 2006, as Sergeant David Ware Day in Cleveland and Bradley County.
Husband, a brave soldier, and above all, a hero. The most unbelievable detail about all of these incredible people is that they are not separate people at all. If you were to take all of the above-mentioned qualities and bundle them together into one person, then you would have the core of a man formerly known to most as Sergeant David Thomas Weir of the United States Army.
Our party, out and two! And I, ready!
His name, his jersey number, and the years that he played for the Bradley Central Bears will be placed on a new locker in our field house alongside other great Bradley Countyans such as Steve Sloan, Bob Johnson, Chris White, Kenny Hooper, who have had lockers purchased in their honor, and many other great Bradley Countyans who've had lockers purchased in their honor and their.
But I'm here to tell each of you, we have a reason to smile, see, and even scream out in pride that Sergeant David Thomas Weir fulfilled his purpose and he answered his calling. One of my brother's favorite sayings was, every man dies, but not every man really lives. I stand here tonight assured that my brother lived. And not only did he live, but he loved, and he was loved. Over the past week, we have experienced an outpouring from this community that has filled our hearts. And on behalf of David's wife and all of her extended family, my parents, my brothers and sister, and all of our extended family, we would like to say a few words of thanks.
Thank you. Come on. offense for the Raiders. Number 21, Kyle Blake. Jared Robinson. Third baseman, number 3, Tyler Brown.
Thank you. run. It's trivia time again. The next question again will be for an 8-piece box of chicken nuggets from Chick-fil-A. And a little bit harder, but not a real hard question this time. The question is, what Braves pitcher ended Pete Rose's 44-game hitting streak in 1978 with a strikeout? Have to come to the press box. Give us the answer. Have to be the first one. Only one Krager for them.
Score of interest in the fifth inning, Walker Valley 4, Cumberland 0. Up next, number 8, Blake Crabtree. third baseman, number 27, Matt Rising Cooper.
Thank you. Thank you.
second baseman, number 37, Corey Lovelace. Number 26, Michael Knight. pass over to Clayton. Number 21, Kyle Clayton.
Thank you.
Knocks for the Raiders. Number 8, Blake Funzak.
Thank you. That's right there.
Short.
tied at 6 in the top of the second. Number 9, Jonathan Coates.
Thank you. has run out. The runner at first, the catcher, number 22, Aaron Short.
Thank you.
with no outs in order at third base, the center fielder, number 26, Michael Knight.
Come on. You need Ben. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Second, the catcher, number 16, Timmy Lynn.